Great. So after an amazing presentation by Vamsi, next up we have Pavitra Kumar Sahu, co-founder and CTO at Qualisec Technologies. And she will be sharing an amazing presentation on 10 steps to secure your APIs. So as part of this segment, we have curated under the technical stage with the theme of connected application. At the end of the segment, I do have some interesting announcement for you to share. So stay tuned while I introduce Pavitra on stage. And in the meantime, if you have any questions, any kind of queries related to Pavitra, please feel free to drop it in the chat box simultaneously. And we can take all those questions at the end of the session when Pavitra finishes her session. So in this session, Pavitra will be talking about specifically the 10 steps to securing your API. And it is a very interesting topic because I've been reading the benefits of modern software development are manifold when the security is introduced. And I think it is very essential as part of the critical APIs of securing it, because there are many of the risks associated when we talk about the APIs, specifically with the meteoric rise of microservices. So I think what matters is the rush to build more applications more quickly. APIs are being used more than ever to connect services and transfer data. And that is why this session has been curated as part of the section, so that Pavitra can share much more in context about 10 key things that needs to be ensured. So I would like to welcome Pavitra. Hi, Pavitra. Again, a very warm welcome to API Days Live India. If you can unmute, you will be able to also stream your audio along with your video, which is really streaming clear and loud. So yes, you can unmute it. Yes, you are unmuted. So you can start streaming your session now.
Yeah. Thank you, Dheeraj. Thank you for the introduction. Hello, guys. Like, good morning, and hope you are all well in these critical situations. This is Pavitra. I'm starting like with the API security, like a hacker's point of view. So is my mic on mute? Yeah, I think I can unmute. So like API security, like the hacker's point of view. So like introducing myself, this is Pavitra, and I am like co-founder and CTO at Qualisec Technology, as well as I'm an ethical hacker and penetration testers. So I help my clients to secure their APIs and secure their application through all the skill set I have, all the skill set my teams have. So like, let's start with a quotation. Like, it's just one small security loophole versus your entire business. Like, it's just a simple and small security loophole that can destroy your whole business, that can affect your business, that can affect your customers, that can affect your revenue, everything. So like, things one, like once again, like before releasing any API, before releasing any software to public, we have to secure it. So let's say like the recent hack due to API issue, like there are some big names here, like the YouTube bug that allowed upload to any channel. Like if the issue is like, I can upload any video to any channel. Like, this is, isn't this amazing? Like the Tinder security vulnerability allow hackers to access account by entering a user mobile number. Like if I have your mobile number, then I can use your Tinder account. So like, this is the kind of things in API issue we have. Like Facebook, Google, like DigiLocker, they have all are like got data breach due to these small APIs issues. Like Facebook itself leaked 533 million user data due to the small security loophole in their API. Google have to shut down their API because of Flow. It data breach around 52 million users data. So yeah, the like this API security is now like capturing, like in the hacking market, capturing a lot of things over there. So like let's talk about like why API security, like why not any other security, why API security is much essential. Because if we talk about like how like we use our API, is like API is to connect services and transfer data. Okay, so like if a hacker exploit the API, he can exploit the database, he can exploit the whole application, even he can exploit into your network, into your environment. So like and lot of people think, yeah, we protect our web application, we protect our mobile application, then we should not go for the API testing and API security testing. But no, this is necessary. Like why I'm talking this, like below here I'm putting 5 points like for API security. To exploiting APIs is more easy nowadays, rather than web application, rather than mobile application, which is like stronger day by day. API is now like the easy target for hackers. And infrastructure secure is does not mean your API is secure. Like I have some few clients who say me that yeah, my infrastructure is secure, I perform network penetration testing, then I will be like I am on the secure end. I am saying that no, like your API, when you release it in the internet, the API is in all over the world. Even a hacker can access the API like without letting you know. So it doesn't mean that your infrastructure is secure, doesn't that means that your application or the API is secure. And one more thing is hacker love API, I too. Like why don't hackers love API? Because API means we just put some changes, some parameter, we changes some things, we changes the business logic and get more vulnerabilities rather than any web application or any mobile application. One more thing is detecting API data breach can take more than a year. Like if I just give a like a data, like OWASP suggest that to detect any data breach, it takes almost 190 days. But for API, the data breach can be detected, can take around 1 year. The Facebook has got data breach and they detect it around after 1 year. The Google as well as get data breach to API and they detect after 1 year. So like after 1 year, we can find that, yeah, our API got breached. But at that time, hacker took lot of credentials, lot of datas, lot of sensitive financial datas. And last but not least, post-COVID, the hacking activities has increased 300%. Like after the COVID, like in this situation, like hackers are very much active over the internet and like perform their best. Like, yeah, so here I just draw a graph, like how a developer is built the API for the user and a hacker can like hacker do exploit. So a developer just create a API that a user will come, access their application and go using their APIs, they can use their data services. Like if they have some financial data services, if they have some like healthcare services, he can access the services. But a hacker, what a hacker do is like he use a tool to access the API and then go to the data services. So in this way, a hacker bypass the client side rules, a hacker easily abuse the API scenarios, and using many proxy tools like Bobsuit, Jab, hacker can easily modify the parameters. So what happened? All the client side rule we set by performing DAST and SAST assessment, that gonna bypass through just a tool. So here, the API is like, now the API is like a open book for a hacker. He can do whatever what he want to do. And like he can send the request to the data server and gather as much as information he can. So like if I talk about this API vulnerabilities category, I personally think there are two categories. One is common vulnerabilities, one is critical vulnerabilities. So in common vulnerabilities, I like all of my experience and all do I the research. There are three kind of common vulnerabilities. What is injections, misconfiguration issue, and rate limiting. We're gonna talk later. And another in the critical, like what are the critical impact over the business, there are business logic flow issue and authentication and authorization issue, which is access control issue. So if I go dig inside that, So most common vulnerabilities, first let's talk about the rate limiting. So we can simply say it's a DDoS problem. Like a DDoS problem means a hacker can put thousands of requests to a service, to a server through just API, and it will like unaccessible the host, and it can be accessible by any other users. And not just DDoS, it can brute force the username, brute force the file, like brute force the forms, brute force the files by just the rate limiting. So there are also, next is misconfiguration issue. The misconfiguration is like a hacker can do, a developer do some misconfiguration changes that affect the APIs badly. Security misconfiguration is commonly a result of insecure default configuration, such as open cloud storage. They open the cloud storage and they did not close it. Misconfigure the HTTP headers, like they did not put any headers, security headers, that is like, let's say, CSP headers and lots of header, the security headers, they did not put it. Unnecessary HTTP method like put, delete, post. So like there are some unnecessary methods that like the developer use while pushing the data to API. So they use many like unnecessary methods that affect the APIs like very easily. And like if we go to injection is like everywhere. In web application, you can find the common vulnerabilities injection. In mobile application, if you go, the common vulnerabilities injection, in as well as in API, the injection is the more common vulnerability, because like it's also a dangerous, like if a application, if API is vulnerable to injections, so like it will capture all the data, it will capture all the host, it will capture all the like database it have. So a injection means a hacker just put small like dangerous code into the application and process it. If the application and if the API is vulnerable to this and cannot detect the input, so it will perform like maybe some SQL injection, maybe some LDAP injection, maybe some OS command injection, which is like more critical rather than these two. Whatever I talk about is like most common, like most commonly in every three application you can find like these vulnerabilities in like, you know, in one of them. So in most common, in like we left the most common, now let's go to the most critical vulnerabilities. So like in most critical vulnerabilities, so there are authentication and authorization issue. So what is authentication and authorization issue? Is like, let's say I am a user and I am having the username of ABC, and a hacker comes out and he just like manipulate the application, went through the API and just put my username and post my just parameter, whatever the things he just put, and it can be like, it can be lead to account takeover, it can be lead to privilege escalation, like both horizontal privilege escalation as well as vertical privilege escalations. So like let's say like a hacker can easily register as a user and can privilege escalate to a admin and capture hold the application. In other way, a hacker, like let's say Pavitra is a hacker and it register his account as name of the Pavitra, and can by modifying the parameter, modifying the sessions, modifying the authentication IDs, and we can went through any of the user's account. And if I talk about like the business logic flow, this is most critical things, and any automation tool cannot ever find this business logic issue, because it's depend upon the how the business flow work. Like if it's a financial application, it's a fintech, then there are some financial transaction will be gonna happen. So if I just give a scenario, let's say I have to buy, there is an e-commerce application using API, I have to buy a pair of shoes at cost of $200. What a hacker can do is like intercept the request, change the price parameter to $200 to $2. So at the price of $2, I can buy the pair of shoes. So this is like one kind of simple example of business logic issue. There are plenty of business logic issue that might means locking some user's account, modify application data such as user credential and permission, price, quantity of the product. Quantity of the product means like if I just buy like one pair of shoes at $200 and I modify the parameter by from one pair to 10 pair of shoes. So at the $200, I can get two pair of shoes, 10 pair of shoes. So this is the actual business impact over the application. So this is where the API is like, we have to secure the APIs in very deeply. So if I, now let's come to the like point, like how we can secure the APIs. So a DAST or SAST security testing is not enough. You have to perform a API security assessment. Like developers come to us, our application, this is our mobile application and we perform the DAST, we perform the SAST and we are secure. But no, your API is like unsecure right now. The APIs you are using, let's say it's built by you or open source API, it can hamper your business as well. So that DAST or SAST does not mean you did perform API assessment. You have to perform the API assessment so that we can find lot of vulnerabilities, lot of issues before going to production. Another thing is never perform traditional pentesting testing, which only aim to search vulnerability randomly. Perform scenario-based testing. Like nowadays, more of the pentesting testing performing only the like searching vulnerability randomly searching, like I put the XSS script, yeah, let's see it is happening or not. I put the SQL script, let's say it's happening or not. No, just go through the scenario basis. Like if the API having some login functionality, then perform the login functionality test cases. If the API having some payment gateway transaction, then perform the payment gateway testing. So in this way, we found like lot of vulnerability. In this way, we got like, we can say that, yeah, our application is more secure right now. And third is like manual pentesting testing is still the king. Like as I previously told you, that in automation, there are thousands of automation tools for like security testing, but they cannot, most of them cannot perform the authentication authorization test cases, cannot perform the business logic. Most probably they did not perform the business proof block because if the business proof means the application, the development team, they create the application using the business flows. So how a automation tool can understand their business flows? So there is always a manual tester, like in the penetration testing field, it's always the king because he will gonna like exploit whole things manually, like exploit, go to the application, change the, like modify the parameter, tamper the data. So he can perform it manually and it's best till yet. And performing continuous penetration testing, like you have to perform continuous penetration testing, not at the early stage, at 1 year, 2 year before we perform the penetration test, that's why our application is still secure. No, because while we just modify, changes the application, it changes the APIs, it will affect certain things. So we have to perform the penetration testing cycle, like in every pre-built, in every time we changes the application, we have to penetrate it. And one more thing is like, don't collect or store unnecessary data from users. Like if we don't need social security number, if we don't need their credit card number, then we don't have to collect their data. Because if a hacker or a group of hacker hack a system and they did not find anything, so like all their effort is gonna go to drain. Right. So if you don't record any data, if you don't record any unnecessary data, don't collect it. And if I talk about like securing some APIs, so we can use, one is like tokens, one is like JSON tokens, Jiroth tokens. So there are some tokens that can be used to secure the APIs. We can use much more services that perform like that provide API security as part of their like system and whole business logic. So now comes to the like important things, like this, why this is API security is still like the easy thing for hacker. So coder in India are hacking vaccine website to get appointment. So probably everybody, you know, like the coin application, the coin that provided by government to book the slot for vaccination. So like when government announced this website for 18 to 45 years, like all of us definitely go to this website and try, I have to book that slot, and unfortunately did not book that slot because in 10 seconds, 20 seconds, all the slot you're gonna fill up, right? So a hacker, what he like, he's not a hacker so-called, but he's a coder. He's built a Python script. Like as previously what I tell the rate limiting, the API in the coin application did not protect it to rate limiting. So he created by in just 2 hours, like I just read the, that magazine is like, he started coding at 9 a.m. and finished it at 11 a.m. So in 2 hours, he built a script that brute force all the things and can help him to like get the appointment, get the slot book. So he just, this small line of code can like break the application and book him a slot. So this is where the API security is more impactable. But because as you know that this is a government website, this definitely they definitely perform the penetration testing over the application. Then why the other thing, like why a coder just put his script and book a slot? Because they did not perform that API security. So this is where API security is much more important. So at like we at CollegeSec, we provide API security, we provide web application security, we provide mobile application security, and lots of security thing. Like we have like 20 of hackers, 20 of penetration testers to perform it manually, to perform it like automatically. So like if I go like around round of all these things, to secure the application, we do not just like depend upon the manual. We have to also depend upon the automation. Like what my ratio is like, if we perform at least like 70-75% of manual testing, we go for the like 20-25% of automation testing. That will coverage more vulnerability, that will give more bugs rather than just choosing one. Yeah, thank you. Like if you have any questions, then yeah, you can directly reach out to me or reach out to our company website, and hope you like my sessions.
Thank you so much, Pavitra. And definitely, I think the session was really useful because I think everyone of us here can imagine the trouble which everyone is facing while booking their vaccination slots, the appointments. And you are very much sharing something very relevant in the context of the current situation. And I'm sure with the tips you have provided, the great insights you have provided, because I think from here, it will only get worse if the right measures are not taken, because as organizations continue to break down monolithic applications into microservices and then move farther down the cloud native path, the use of APIs will continue to grow. And potentially grow more vulnerable, like you also shared as part of this session. Mm-hmm. So that ensuring that the 10 best practices which you have showcased are not just followed, but also maybe guarantee that 100% API security. But I think it will definitely will go a long way. And once again, I really would like to thank you for sharing your contact details as well. Because of the time limitations, we might not be able to take some of the questions here. So the audience can reach out to you directly on chat as well as through your email later. But once again, like I said, really appreciate your contribution and your time to come forward and help the Indian API community as part of this session. So thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you so much, Dheeraj. And thank you, like,